The stricter enhanced community quarantine or ECQ in Metro Manila, Rizal, Laguna, Cavite, and Bulacan begins today to prevent the novel coronavirus from spreading further. Curfew hours have been extended from 6 p.m. to 5 a.m. Only essential workers will be allowed to leave their homes as well as those buying food or medicines. Gatherings of more than 10 people are also banned, while malls are closed except for groceries and drugstores. The new restrictions will be in effect until April 4.
Pagdating naman po sa detection, no, mag-establish po kami tayo ng mga Daravi-like centers at the community na maghahanap po ng mga suspect cases, ititrace sila, i-contact trace at i-isolate. Magbabahay-bahay po tayo na maghahanap ng mga taong meron po mga symptoms. Isinasapinal na po ang pagbibigay ng assistance. Meron naman po tayong press briefing sa Lunes. Sa Lunes po, nag-commit po ang ating economic team na unang-una malalaman na kung saan kukunin yung pagkuhanan natin ng assistance at pangalawa kung magkano yung assistance at kung ano yung pamamaraan para madistribute ito.
The Health Professionals Alliance supports the shift to ECQ, but it appeals to the government to boost the COVID-19 referral network for hospitals and to intensify contact tracing efforts. The group also calls for transportation for health workers and the strict adherence to the priority list of COVID-19 vaccine recipients. The Philippines records more than 9,000 new COVID-19 cases for the third straight day. This brings the country's total number of infections to over 721,000. Over 105,000 of them are considered active cases. 11 more people died of the disease, raising the death toll to 13,170. Recoveries stand at more than 603,000. Based on the latest data, the country's positivity rate is now at nearly 20%. That means one out of five people tested is positive for the disease. The World Health Organization recommends a positivity rate of 5% or lower for at least 14 days before reopening the economy. Over 9,000 police officers have been deployed to quarantine control checkpoints across the National Capital Region and nearby provinces. Unlike last year's enhanced community quarantine situation, the body temperatures of those passing through will be no longer checked. Instead, authorized workers will only be asked to present their valid company IDs or certificates of employment. Authorities promise to be flexible in the implementation of ECQ restrictions, assuring maximum tolerance and no arrests as much as possible.
Papabalikin sila o warningan, tapos yung ordinansa na inisyo ng mga NGOs, i-issuean sila ng ticket. Kanina, hinighlight doon, dapat mayroong mga gym na pwedeng pagdalan sa kanila, papanoorin sila ng paalala para sa pagpatupad itong ECQ. Yung arrest, hanggat maaari, maliban na lang siguro kung sila ay talagang magiging hostile o makakasakit na hindi lang sa pulis o kung kanino man, doon papasok yun.
We will be compassionate for those who are on their way home. Alam naman po ng ating mga kapulisan at mga barangay yan. Kaya lang, may window po yan. Pagka nakarating po ng mga 7:30 to 8 o'clock, maghihigpit na po talaga yan dahil yung nilaan na duration po ng travel nyo ay hindi na po siguro maaaring ganun katagal pa.
The public is prohibited from attending Holy Week celebrations in the so-called NCR Plus after the government placed those areas on the strictest lockdown classification for a week. From Holy Monday to Easter Sunday, churches in Metro Manila, Bulacan, Cavite, Laguna, and Rizal will be closed. Religious celebrations will also be held online, similar to last year when the pandemic began. The Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines reminds the public to observe health protocols and to pray for those who are suffering the most amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Workers affected by stricter quarantine measures in Metro Manila and nearby provinces are appealing for help from the government. Some public utility drivers fear mobility restrictions will further slash their earnings. Other delivery drivers, meanwhile, say the closure of most establishments will likely affect their work.
Katulad ho namin bumibiyahe sa TNBS po. Andalang ho ng pasero. Wala na hong lumalabas eh. Siyempre, Baboundary pa ho kami. Magkano lang naman ho ang sa maghapon na kitain.
Sana pagkatapos ng isang linggo na to, sana maibalik naman yung magandang biyaya na sa susunod na linggo po.
Pinapahirapan na rin yung tao eh. Mga taong bayan eh. Lockdown na lockdown eh. Saan mahanap ng pera? Alam, pambayad sa araw-araw bahay. So, sa buwan na ng buhay, tubig, ilaw. Kung na lockdown yan eh, wala naman tayong anak buhay na iba na naman.
Malacanang has said aid will be given during a one-week enhanced community quarantine period, but details like how much and when the assistance will become available are still being finalized. The government also promises to distribute food packs in poor communities. A group calls on big companies to pay their employees who will not be able to report to work during the implementation of the enhanced community quarantine. The Employers Federation of the Philippines, or ECOP, says the ECQ will have minimal impact on most companies since it falls during the Holy Week when most firms are implementing reduced working hours anyway. But ECOP says employees who will be most affected are those under the No Work, No Pay scheme. ECOP now calls on big firms to waive such policy during the one-week ECQ.
So pinapakiusapan namin yung malalaking alakang magagawa doon sa mga micro eh. Talaga hindi mo naman sila pwede magbayad ng ano. Pero yung malalaki na miyembro namin, pinapakiusapan namin, sana kargahin na lang nyo yung Lunes, Martes, Miyerkules na ano, para hindi naman masyadong mahirapan yung mga tao nila.
Public transportation will remain available but with limited capacity in Metro Manila and nearby provinces under the enhanced community quarantine. Starting today, Transportation Secretary or Undersecretary Artemio Ochi Tuason says public transport vehicles will be limited to authorized persons outside of the residences. At the Ninoy Aquino International Airport, only 1,500 international inbound passengers will be accepted daily, while maritime transport will be limited at 50% capacity. Trains will only run up to 30% capacity, although the MRT, the LRT, the PNR have already announced they will be closed until Easter Sunday due to maintenance work. Provincial bus stations will also have limited operations.
Siguro mo, medyo natatakot pa yung mga kababayan natin na lumabas para dahil nga sa sinasabi nilang lockdown. Halos yung mga nasasakay lang namin, yung mga nagtatrabaho.
Regular po ang biyahe namin. Yung pasahero, kumunti nga lalo. Pero bilang transport service, ginagawa pa rin po namin yung aming trabaho na maglingkod pa rin, magservisyo pa rin. Nag-adjust lang kami sa mga bebiyahing bus.
Panic buying was seen in several stores in Metro Manila just moments after the government announced stricter quarantine restrictions in areas under the so-called NCR Plus bubble. Online orders also soared as people chose not to line up at supermarkets, but the government assured the public there won't be a shortage in supplies.
Wala pong dahilan para mag-panic buying. Hindi po tayo mauubusan dahil bukas naman po ang mga merkado.
The Agriculture Department also said the delivery of products and agricultural input will not be hampered due to the new restrictions. Power utility firm Meralco suspends all disconnection activities until April 15. Meralco says the move is meant to ease the burden of its customers during the enhanced community quarantine. Meralco earlier announced it would continue vital operations such as meter readings despite stricter quarantine measures. It also urges customers to reach out to them online for any inquiry as a precaution to the rising number of COVID-19 cases.